So that's what, that's in part what I liked, the images it, it described, like the guy trying to resuscitate the chicken, and mostly of these images just, they stayed here. It's a very short story, it's 12 pages, but I thought it could give enough for 80 minute films. And that's part of it. I wanted to keep the anxiety of the fear of when is he going to commit a tragedy. Mm-hmm. And the story is more, the short story is more, the structure is more atemporal. Like it's not so linear. He's working in this place, and at the same time he's also working with his mother. And so I tried to make a linear structure that will give an evolution to the character, because in the short story he stays like as a kid during the whole lecture.
And when I watch these scenes of him working in the restaurant, is that a common way to kill chickens with the Hoover?
No, it's part of his idea, his fictional idea of I think he's sweet and he wants to kill the chicken in the softest way, and it also is a part of the fiction of he can bring them back to life with how do you say that?
The resuscitation, yeah, the breathing,
yeah,
in.
Yeah, breathing in. And that's part of, I think, the fundamental image that brought the author, Jean-Marie Le Plaisir, to write about it, because he told me his wife told him in a chicken restaurant, like isolated like that, she saw a kid that had on his left hand the head of the chicken and the right hand the body. And he was trying to stick it together, and he couldn't understand why he couldn't. So I think this was like the spark for the author to begin and write the story. Like this person that believes, that doesn't understand these two parts, like imagination of kids.
And speaking of Yo's magical powers or premonitions, these kind of glimpses that we start to see throughout the film, how do you interpret them? Are these real, or are we to think that they are really happening in his head? Is he seeing them?
I don't know. While I was making the film, it's interesting, because it's not that I have... While I do the film, I discover stuff about it. And while I was shooting it, I discovered it was a film about the unconscious, and about dreams and about desires. And an example of that is this shot when you see the highway, and then there's a crane that goes down, and you find the tunnel, the dark tunnel. For me, it was like we're going to be in between reality and the inner unconscious part of the character. And yo in Spanish means I. So it went well together. In French, yo doesn't mean anything. The author told me yo in Korean means a mattress.
Okay.
So it's very open interpretation.
Yeah, I was wondering this about the name. If it, I was trying to figure out why he would have this kind of I as a name, and if maybe this was when he was young, he didn't really have a way to understand a separate name.
Yeah, I don't know. That's a choice of the author, and I liked the Mexicanization of the word.
Would anyone else out here like to ask a question? Okay. Yeah.
I'd like to ask the cast about the casting of the main character. Is he a professional actor, or did you find him somewhere?
And all of the cast is non-professional actors.
And why did you choose to work with them?
Why did I choose him?
To work with non-professional actors.
Oh, because of of the energy they give to the movie. And I've been experimenting with that for 3 films, and now I'm preparing a project with actors. I'm not so like dogmatic. It's the energy. I think when you cast non-professional actors, a big part of the character will be defined with this real person. And in a magical way, because I didn't know that before I chose them, their biographies is really close to the biography of the character. For example, Yo, he's super intelligent. Like, it's a pity he's not here, but he speaks very well. He's very cultivated. He's studying. He was studying communications when I first saw him. He did some radio, so he had a good control of his voice. When he was a kid, when he was 6 years old, and he was going to enter the primary school, or just a kid's school, the director of the school told he was mentally retarded just because he couldn't articulate well the R. And he said, she sent him back and said to her mother, "Your kid does not belong to this school." And the mother took him to another school, and he was first of the class. And so he felt, in a way, he identified with the character. And the mother, she has a kid who has a mental problem also. She's 20 something, and the guy, the lover, he's my uncle, and I've seen him mad and like angry, so I thought he could be the bad guy. And the other persons, we found them in different places, like Melody Petit, Jenny, she's the one who sleeps with him. She does porno films, pornographic, and it was really nice to meet her, and she openly says she's an exhibitionist and she likes to be watched, and it's nice to have this contact also with different parts of society that if it wasn't because of this film I won't meet. And the friends of Yo, we with the editor we made fun that they were Batman and Robin of Yo. They work in this place. We found them over there. And it's for them it's an experience that happens just once in life. And so I think that there is a lot of energy that they bring to the film. A lot of they're very really motivated, and they learn really speed. The acting of Yo at the beginning of the shooting was not the same as at the end of the shooting.
Did you show it chronologically somehow?
Almost, yeah, almost.
Yeah, there's someone in the back.
Yes. Yeah. Is your background from documentary film or fiction film, or where have you, how's your way?
Yes, I really come from both. I began my audiovisual, well, first visual exploration with still photography. And a friend gave me a camera, but it was not working well, so I could only take pictures with a timer. You know, when I clicked and the picture will come 10 seconds after. So I had to, my first pictures are just like that, just trying to predict when a moment would be interesting. And then I had my first video camera, and I was obsessed by shooting everything, all my daily life. My family, friends, and my adolescence, and then I think it was a way of relating also to the world behind the lens of the camera, and then I started filmmaking, and I made documentaries, and then I think yes, the casting of non-professional actors comes from the documentary world, I think, and I don't really like to separate documentary and fiction. For me, it's cinema.
Anyone else? Okay, yes.
Yes, and I'd like to know what inspired you about the short story
follow and go on. And so I try to respect these moments of like inspiration. Yeah, there's not like a topic. Maybe I have a cousin. Well, he's not my cousin, but I don't know the name in English. He's the son of my brother, and he has some problems. He's mentally retarded, and I love him very much, and he loves me very much. And when he turned 16, 17, he began to have this sexual attraction to women. You know, he had this necessity, and so that made me think a lot in the short story of this moment with this kind of characters. They have the sexual need. How will society will react to that? And it's very complicated. Because I don't know, for example, he will say hello to my girlfriend or my other brother's girlfriend, and he will hold it like for so long, and then like innocently he will put his hands in his breast and her breasts, for example. And so this was very like inaccurate socially, right? And I was interested by this conflict.
Yeah, I think that when you had your the scenes between Yo and the 11-year-old girl, they really walked this very fine line between being sort of innocent and playful, and then being very sexually charged and creepy. And I think that was sort of what I thought was the beauty of the film as a whole. You talked about the next project you have with professional actors. Do you have a working title for this?
No working title. No working title, but I don't know. It's like romantic short stories or something like that. Yeah, like I don't know. I have called four different screenwriters, and some people come from theater also, so they're doing short stories, very very free love stories about how relations are reshaping a little bit in our society.
Well, I hope that we'll be able to see it again in Stockholm when
it's
finished.
I hope.
Thank you very much, and thank you for your questions.